Hi, Dr. Gniady. Thank you for seeing me today. I feel like I have a lump or something in my throat. I can't clear it. I can't cough. I'm really concerned. Can you help me?
Yes, this is probably one of the more common things we see people coming into the office with. I think the throat is sort of a scary place for a lot of people, and their doctors oftentimes, because it's one of those places that's kind of tough to see. Your general doctor looking in the back of your throat with a little tongue depressor isn't going to be able to really check on things down there. But we see people in with this complaint day in and day out. The most important thing really for us to do is to get a look down there. We do that typically with just a little tiny flexible camera. It slips right down through the nose and lets us see all the way down to the bottom of the throat. The vast majority of the time when we see these types of things, it's nothing big and scary. Can be something as simple as a little bit of acid reflux in the throat, sometimes just some tight muscles there that can make us feel like something is stuck. But generally when we can get a look down, we can figure out what's going on, and then we can move forward trying to help you get some relief.
So this is a test that you do to try and determine what's in my throat. Is it painful?
It's not. We use a little spray in the nose. It opens you up a little bit, gives us some more room for the scope to slip through. It numbs up the nose a bit as well. The front teeth may even get a little bit numb by the time we're done. But it's a little bit funny having something in the nose, admittedly. But most people don't report any pain associated with it.
So after the test, what's next?
Well, we need to see what's there first and foremost, and obviously if there is something of concern, then we need to talk about what to do about that. But as I said, most of the time it's something much more common, and we would try to get you some relief based on what's going on there. If it is some irritation or inflammation, then we would want to address the source of that. As I said, oftentimes these can be related to some acid coming up from the stomach.
If you do find that it's some kind of a lesion or a tumor, what would we do in that case?
Well, we'd need to find out a little bit more about it. And generally, the next step there would be getting a biopsy, taking a small piece of it, letting our pathology colleagues take a look at it so that they could tell us exactly what it is. Sometimes that's something we can do here in the office. Sometimes it's something I have to take you to the operating room to do. The vast majority of things we see down there, even if they are of some concern, are very treatable as long as we catch them early enough.
Okay, so our first step is the testing, and then it's potential treatment based on what it is. Will I then be able to swallow normally?
Yeah, the vast majority of the time we get people relief from this. We call that feeling a globus sensation. It's the name of the symptom, and it can be difficult at times, but we can almost always get people relief.
Great, thank you. You've relieved my concerns. I appreciate it. I think we should go ahead and get that test scheduled.
Sounds good.